डबल इंटीग्रेशन, इवैल्यूएट डबल इंटीग्रेशन एक्स वाई डी ए वेर डी इज द रीजन बाउंडेड बाय y इक्वल टू x एंड y इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर. सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू इवैल्यूएट, वी वांट टू इवैल्यूएट दिस इन डबल इंटीग्रेशन ओवर द रीजन d, वेर d इज बाउंडेड बाय दिस टू कर्व y इक्वल टू x एंड y इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर. सो नाउ स्टेप फर्स्ट, वी वांट टू डिटरमाइन लोअर एंड अपर लिमिट ऑफ x एंड y. फॉर दैट फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिटरमाइन इंटरसेक्टिंग पॉइंट, सेक्टिंग पॉइंट्स ऑफ द गिवन कर्व. सो फर्स्ट गिवन y इक्वल टू x एंड y इक्वल टू एक्स स्क्वायर. नाउ हियर LHS इज सेम इम्प्लाइज RHS इज ऑल्सो सेम, सो एक्स स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू x. सो वी कैन राइट दिस एज एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस x इज इक्वल टू जीरो. From LHS, if we take x outside, inside the bracket, x minus 1 equal to 0. So this implies either x is equal to 0 or x minus 1 equal to 0. So this implies x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 1. Now if x is equal to 0, if x is equal to 0, then since y equal to x implies y equal to also 0, and if x is equal to 1, then y is also 1. So here intersecting points are, this implies intersecting points is equal to 0, 0 and 1, 1. 1, 1. Now next, we are doing going to draw this graph. So this region is bounded, this closed region is bounded between the point 0, 0 and 1, 1. So first y equal to x, we want to draw y equal to x. Since we know that this is a straight line passing through origin, if we consider two points, say x is equal to 0, y is 0, if x is 1, y is 1, if x is 2, y is 2, say here it is 1, 2, 1, 2, then this is a straight line, say 1, 1 here, okay, this is a straight line passing through the origin, okay. So for y equal to x square, again it is a parabola, we know that, it's the equation of parabola. If we determine 3 to 4 points, say 0, 0, x is 0, y is 0, x is 1, y is 1, x is minus 1, then y is 1, for 2 it is 4, and for minus 2 it is again 4. So here say minus 1, minus 2. So for 1, 1 it is 1, for 2 it is say here 4, 4, for minus 1 it is 1, and minus 2 it is equal to again 4. So if you join these points, then this is the closed region bounded by these two curve y equal to x and y equal to x square between 0 and 1. Now to cover this area, you can consider either vertical strip or horizontal strip. So first we are going to consider here vertical strips. I am writing this region again here. We are going to draw this region again between 0 and 1. So this is the region between 0 and 1. Okay, so this is the curve y equal to x square, and this is what y equal to x. So if you consider here vertical strips, then these strips, this point is what 0, 0, and this point is 1, 1. So if we consider this strip, then it enters at y equal to x square. These strips enter at y equal to x square and leaves at y equal to x. So the limit of y is, so here limit x square less than or equal to y less than or equal to x, and such a strip we are going to vary from 0 to 1. 0 to 1. You can see here such a strips. If we consider here strip, one strip, then such a strip we are going to put from this point to this point. So here 0 to 1, so 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, and therefore the given double integration d xy dA is equal to double integration xy dA is equal to 0 to 1 Fubini's strong theorem, since y limit of y is given in terms of x, so this is equal to xy dy dx. Why dy dx? Because the limit of y is given in terms of x, so first we want to evaluate an integration with respect to x, y. This is 0 to 1, take x outside, integration of y is y square by 2, and the limit is x to x square dx. So here if you put upper and lower limit, take 1 by 2 outside, it is 0 to 1 x, it is x raised to 4 for upper limit, and for lower limit it is x square dx. So if you simplify this, it is equal to 1 by 2 integration 0 to 1 x raised to 5, sorry, x raised to 5 minus x cube dx. This is equal to 1 by 2 integration of x raised to 5 is x raised to 6 divided by 6 minus integration of x cube is x raised to 4 divided by 4. Limit is from 0 to 1. So here for lower limit the value of this inside the bracket is 0, for upper limit it is 1 by 6 minus 1 by 4. If you take LCM here, it is 1 by 2, 4 minus 6 divided by 24. So this is equal to minus 1 by 2 minus 2 by 24. So this 2 will get cancelled here, and it is equal to minus 1 by 24. So the lower limit is what? It is what? X square to x. Lower limit is what? X square. Upper limit is x. So if you want to correct this, it is what? X square to x. Here also x square to x. So it becomes x raised to 4 plus x square minus x raised to 5 plus x cube. It is minus x raised to 6 plus 6, and it is what? It is minus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 4 minus 4 plus 6. So this become plus 1 by 24. You can verify this integration by using maxima also. So first we are going to draw the region. So plot by using, we are going to draw this both the curve on same x and y axis. So by using the command plot 2d, enter the first function is x, second function is x square bracket completed, then we want to draw this graph from x is equal to say minus 2 to plus 2, and if we enter, you can see, so this is the graph, this is the y equal to x. You can see here the equation of this blue line, blue line is what? Y equal to x. For red line it is y equal to x square, and this is the area, this is the region bounded between, you can see here, this area, this closed area is bounded by curve y equal to x and y equal to x square between 0 and 1. So you can cover this area by using either vertical strip or horizontal strips. So in the first case we use vertical strip. Now you can evaluate this integration by using the command integrate, then again integrate xy, and the limit is from y, limit of y is what? X square. Lower limit is x square and upper limit is x. Similarly for x, the lower limit is 0, upper limit is 1. So if we enter here, sorry, it is x into y. We want to enter here x into y. So now if you enter, it is what? 1 by 24. So now we can see here the value of the integration is what? 1 by 24. Similarly, you can cover this region by using horizontal strip also. For example, so here if you use the horizontal strips, this is the area bounded between 0 and 1. So this is 0 and this is 1. Okay, this is the point 0, 0. Now if you consider the horizontal strips, then it enters at x is equal to y, since this strip is parallel to x axis, and leaves at x is equal to under root of y, since y equal to x square implies x is equal to under root of y. So now and such a strip we are going to vary from this point to this point, so that is y equal to 0 to y equal to 1. So now for horizontal strips, the limits are 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 1, and under root of y less than or equal to x less than or equal to under root of y. So this double integration, double in first case we evaluate first dy and then dx. Now here the limit of x is given in terms of y, so first we want to evaluate x and then y, and therefore double integration xy dA becomes 0 to 1 y to under root of y xy dx dy dx dy. First we want to evaluate x, integration with respect to x, since the limit of x is given in terms of y. So it is 0 to 1 y outside, the integration of x is x square by 2, and lower limit is y, upper limit is under root of y dy. So take 1 by 2 outside. If you take 1 by 2 outside, then it is equal to 0 to 1 for upper limit, it is under root of y square, so it is y, and for lower limit it is y square dy. So now if you multiply this y inside the bracket, then it is equal to 0 to 1 y square minus y cube dy. Now the integration of y square is y cube by 3 minus integration of y cube is what? Y 4 by 4, and the limit is from 0 to 1. So it is equal to 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4. There is mistake somewhere. It enters at y to y cube. Yeah, it is okay. Here is the 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is outside the bracket. Here is also 1 by 2. Now, here is 1 by 2. Outside the bracket is 1 by 2. So, this is equal to 1 by 2, 4 minus 3 divided by 12. This is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 12 is equal to 1 by 24. So, you can check here. You can, if you consider horizontal or vertical strip, the value of the integration remains same, that is what, 1 by 24. You can apply maxima also. In the first case, we here if you copy, or I'm writing here, integrate, again integrate, since it is a double integration, integrate, then x, the function is x into y. Then, or you can enter first function also. So f of xy is equal to f of xy is equal to say x into y. Sorry. So f of xy is equal to x into y. And now by using the command integrate one more time integrate, and f of xy. Now first we are going to enter the limit of x, so x from square root of y, y to square root of y, so y to square root of y completed, sorry, bracket completed, then the limit of y is from 0 to 1. 0 to 1. So now if you enter here, you can check here integrate value of the integration is 1 by 24, here also 1 by 24, but here first we evaluate integration with respect to y, here we evaluate integration, you can check here, okay, you can check here, first we take an integration with respect to y first and then x. Now here integration with respect to x first, that is from y to square root of y, and the limit, then integration with respect to y. In both the cases you can see here the value of the integration is what, 1 by 24. So here you can also check, first we consider the vertical strip and then we consider horizontal strip, and we get value of the integration is what, 1 by 24.